In one of my previous videos, I said that all ideologies suffer from the problem of having a very small minority of intelligent people and a vast majority of morons. I said this was true across the board for all ideologies except Marxism, which is wholly fucking retarded. So today I want to go into a series where I talk about the retarded antics of YouTube's Marxists. First, let's go after the low-hanging fruit. For those of you who were early subscribers of mine, you may have remembered a kid named Voice of Reason 467, who I had an exchange with, who was turned out to be a mentally retarded kid. We didn't know it at the time. He was a Zeitgeister. But today, I think I found his long-lost Marxist brother. His channel is called Angry Bastards. And he even comes with his own speech impediment, too. This is perfect. He might actually be the worst Marxist channel on YouTube, and that's saying a lot. All right, so this will be some sort of a Ragnarok style video where I go through some of his videos. Now I'm going to be avoiding most of the MRA shit and the interviews. As I said before, I don't really care about gender ideologies, and his interviews are so painful that even the interviewees are cringing. I can't imagine you sitting through this yourself. Okay, so in the video titled The Postmodernist Thinker, Episode 5, Stefan Molyneux is talking shit again. Stefan Molyneux, which if you're new to my channel, I've been very critical of. Stefan Molyneux makes a comment that socialists have a very childlike view of inequality and talks about the comic with a person living inside of a cardboard box in front of a wealthy financial building. Then all of a sudden it forwards to the now grown-up kid, goth kid from South Park. Now I'm going to read to you what he responds with. And I want you to tell me what he's saying, because I'm clueless. Quote, so you're implying your logical fallacy off a satirical cartoon, which could also imply you're a fucking joke yourself when you're basing your ideology from a joke in itself. You get my drift? Logic. And he does a little Cult of Dusty logic thing. Like Cult of Dusty. Piece of shit you are. I have several questions. How is a cartoon a logical fallacy? This cartoon picture is satire? If it is, what is it satirizing? Funny how you talk about Cult of Dusty's logic when you also fall in the same trap that he does, where he calls everything that he wants to divorce himself from satire. How is Molyneux applying he's a joke? Was Rothbard trolling people when he wrote about anarcho-capitalism? Is that why it's a joke? Look, don't ask people if you get your drift, if you can't even communicate a fucking point, okay? What you just said was totally incoherent, but this too will be satire, right? You'll end up, oh, this is satire. Molyneux is shown again, and he's talking about how in capitalism, you work hard, and you'll be rewarded, even though we start at different places on the race, we advance according to how hard we try. Now, Gothkid said this is a logical fallacy, because most Americans work three jobs and can't pay their bills. So we've established some facts today. One, Angry Bastards is one of those people who likes to say that anything he disagrees with or thinks is wrong is a logical fallacy. Two, he doesn't think it's fallacious to make up statistics. So from the Bureau of Labor Statistics, only 5% of all employed people were juggling more than one position, a decrease since 1995 when it was 6.8%. So he either thinks it's not fallacious to make up statistic, or he actually thinks that 5% it qualifies as most Americans. Molyneux flashes back and talks about income mobility across generations, and how typically money does not stay within families after a couple generations. Now, after that, he plays a clip implying that he's rebutting that comment of when Bernie Madoff was busted for his little Ponzi scheme, as if that's a rebuttal to what he's saying about income mobility through generations. Okay, so let's take that as a thing. Bernie Madoff made a bunch of money, didn't pass it off to his kids because he went to jail. So what you're basically doing is just giving evidence that Molyneux is right, if we were to accept the premise that Bernie Madoff is some kind of ANCAP fucking entrepreneur. Then Molyneux goes into about talking about how the gun enforces socialism and that social programs all come from threats of force. Gothkid comes back and lists off a bunch of countries that are, quote, socialist or, quote, Marxist base. He doesn't mention the big ones like Vietnam or the DBRK, but he does mention Greece. Fucking Greece. Then he calls Molyneux a hypocrite, which is true, but his reasoning for calling Molyneux a hypocrite is stupid. He says that he's a hypocrite because he pays his taxes. Oh, wait. As if, one, Molyneux wants to pay taxes, and two, by the way, what happens if you don't pay your taxes? Oh, that's right. You prove him fucking right, because they will cut him and take his fucking money away. And then I love that little conservative thing he does at the end, like, if you don't like Canada, you can get out. So next video, Nigel Farage says what? He shows a clip of Nigel Farage being unhappy with people comparing him to basically calling him the European or the British Donald Trump, and sees himself more as Henry VIII. Goth Kid thinks he means he wants to decapitate his wife. In the next video, what is libertarianism? In reply to Rocky Mr. E, he says that the definition of libertarian differs regionally. Okay, so do the words liberal and fag. Then he defines libertarianism by playing someone critiquing Ayn Rand. You know, that lady that denounced libertarianism as subjectivism? Oh, by the way, all libertarians are randroids, every single one of them. Next video, Angry Bastards, diss to the ANCAP. Now, it's him rapping about how he hates Scotty M and rocking Mr. Ego, and he even implies that Arini is an ANCAP, too. Of course, he's stuttering and mumbling, and even when he raps. Go and watch this video and tell me how many Cheetos he ate before you cringed. My score was -1. Next video, Postmodern Thinker, Episode 4, Christopher Cantwell jumps/fucks the shark. Probably one of the most mumbliest videos I've seen yet. The first part of this I couldn't even understand until he said the words nonsensical rant. Oh, irony. Christopher Cantwell goes into a typical tirade about how the state is corrupt and they're going after activists and they're disrupting families and blah, 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 blah. You know, typical Cantwell stuff. He goes into a lot of detail, but Goth Kid refutes it by just saying that it's empty rhetoric, empty right-wing rhetoric. I think that's a logical fact. Nope, not going there. Christopher Cantwell goes into a long rant about political libertarian strategies that promote libertarians as socially liberal and fiscally conservative, or like Penn Jillette says, left on sex, right on money. Then Goth Kiss says that he refutes this claim by saying that his God and Savior, quote-unquote, Ron Paul, wrote for the KKK and the Aryan Brotherhood, and that Christopher Cantwell denies that. And that makes him a fascist. I assume you're probably done laughing by now. So first of all, no, Ron Paul had writers who wrote for his own newsletter that was saying racist shit, not for the KKK and the Aryan Brotherhood. Secondly, Ron Paul... I don't think that Cantwell is denying that anywhere. Perhaps you could show me. Secondly, Ron Paul is not Cantwell's or any ANCAP's God and Savior. This already is just impeachable as not knowing what the fuck you're talking about. Also, fascism is an economic term that explicitly denounces the economic prescriptions that Ron Paul supports. Then he plays like 8 minutes of Cantwell, which is totally unfucking necessary, right? Because he only is going to talk about like the last couple sentences of it. So, I mean, and none of it's really relevant to what he's going to say after that. In fact, what he actually says isn't really relevant to what he says after all. But because he just says that, okay, libertarianism is wrong because the term was stolen from a German socialist and we took the words. Words cannot actually describe how absolutely retarded this argument is. So I'm not even going to try. All right, in the next video, an open letter to Scotty M. Part 2. You're a racist cunt. He responds to a video that Scotty M. did talking about why, as a Scotsman, he supports the Confederate battle flag and explaining the Scottish roots of the flag design and the Scottish history of the South. But of course, this means that Scotty supports slavery and Nazism because he'd get punched if he said that in Boston. I'm done for today. worms